What's up, guys? This is Coin Sniper. I literally just made like a tw it was like a 20-minute video. Let me put my headphones down. It was too loud. My music playing was too loud, and it was nothing eventful anyway. So, long story short, I wasn't planning on taking today off, but I had an MRI I had to get done. Two MRIs yesterday, one today. A yearly checkup for multiple sclerosis. And they are not fun. So, needless to say, took the day off. And it was kind of an eventful day. I went to the coin shop. Well, my coin shop. Closest he is like almost 20 miles away. But anyway, on the way back, I went to the bank, dropped off some stuff, and as always, asked if they had half dollars. And the one guy's like, "Oh, I got $100 worth of half dollars." The bank, you know, their customer wrapped rolls, and it was like $100 worth. And I was like, "Well, either I'm gonna hit the jackpot or not." Well, that's life. It hits you with some clat. That's life. Yeah, it was a lot of fun. I did find in there a proof at least. It's nothing to write home about. As I nail the camera, it's a 1978 S proof. You can't even really tell because it's all scruffy until you tilt it and you see that flash. That's something, right? So, oh yeah. So the coin shop. So I went to the coin shop. Coin shop. Went to the coin shop. Picked up some stuff. And my coin shop was actually kind of funny. It was like, I was like, "Dude, I'm not used to seeing so much stuff here." And he's like, "Yeah, I've been getting a lot of stuff in, a lot of stuff in, a lot of stuff out." It was quite interesting. So what did I pick up? Well, I had like a couple left in the Simpsons series that I needed to pick up. Check this one off. You got Mr. Krusty the Clown. Didn't have him. These get pretty pricey, so I like the price and I picked it up. So that's from 2020. I picked that up. What else did I pick up when I was there? I made that 20-minute video and now I'm just like, can't even remember what I picked up. I didn't put it in Castle yet. Let me grab my glove. So I like stuff from Tokelau. I like Tokelau stuff. Tokelau has like this fish series, and I think this year there was the porcupine, which was 2021, I believe. This year it was something else, and this one was from 2020. And I gotta open up a brand new case of 39 millimeter capsules. So there's the good old Queen Tokelau 2020. Flying fish. Isn't that cool? So I picked that up. Back in the flip. Gonna go into the capsule. I just haven't gotten to the capsules. I was just digging through all those half dollars. They're all clad. Not fun. But if you didn't see the stream last week, I did pick up these. This is like some of the harder, one of the hardest years to get on the Kookaburra. And it might be my favorite one, because as much as I hate spiders, that spider web that it's hanging on is really cool. This is 2008 Kookaburra. They usually go for like, I gotta tell you, it took me a long time to get these. They usually go in the like 60 to 70 or more range, somewhere like that. got that one more checked off the list. Also got another 96. This is a semi-hard year to get. I picked up this year 96 when I was in Grove, but now I have two. This is the second one. So I got that. Picked up another 2012. Almost done with this Kook set, which is making me very happy. What else did I get? Picked up this from the coin shop around my birthday. I think this has a mintage of 10K from the Solomon Islands. This is part of a series too. This is the Mary Reed. Really love ship coins, plus it's got a cross and bones right there in the front.
My love.
Very detailed coin. I love this coin. I actually been wanting this for a while, and I just couldn't get it for a decent price. And kind of these were in our last stream. This celebrates the 100th anniversary of when they opened up King Tut's tomb. So this is what they call reverse frosted. Sierra Leone's putting out some really nice stuff. Like, they have this lion coin that, God, it's really expensive now. So I have a feeling these are going to jump up in price too. These are really cool. I got the brand new Tiger round from Comsco. The prices on these are insane. Like, there was no low price starting on these. Like, these are just straight, like, couldn't get these for less than 36 to 40 was, like, the cheapest they were. And trust me, I look all over the place. There's that security feature, 999, and AG. Always love that. Comsco always puts out really nice. I've noticed now that Comsco, their minting is just getting so good that, like, their coins have actually, around, I should say, have actually had a rainbow glow to them, some of them. Like, I know the new Chiwu Chiwang, Chi whatever, the new Chiwus, they got, like, a glint of like, a rainbow when you tilt them. I don't have it in front of me, but they're really cool. So, there's that, and let's see what else we got. I already had this in my videos. This is the clotted leopard from Cambodia. This is another that's been putting out some really cool stuff. Kingdom of Cambodia. I also got the colored version. Very cool. And now I just picked up the Lost Tigers of Cambodia. I think this has a mintage of 10K as well. And the colored version of this one is really cool. So check this out. Look at how glossy that is. That is beautiful. Really like that one. What else did I get? The new DC series. These were on pre-order for me for like an eternity. Finally got them. And actually, the previous, like with like Superman and everything, was all coming out with Nui on the back. And now it's Tuvalu, which makes me happy because Tuvalu, they put a lot of effort into their coins. So a lot of times you get really good quality coins. And the second best thing, when Tuvalu sends their stuff out, I'm pretty sure that almost all their stuff comes in capsules, which makes my life hella easy. Capsules are not getting any cheaper. So I got that. And what else is there? I don't know if I ever showed you the slab I got. I like Pegasus. Pegasi? I don't know. Great Britain PCGS PR69 2017 peak. I think it's just a really cool design. And just happened to pick it up at a decent price, and I like that slab. At my coin show, I think it was like a long, at least 2 or 3 months ago, I picked this up. 2013 Tokelau Year of the Snake MS70. I'll hold it there if you want to scan it. But I don't know if it brings up the numbers. This thing is beautiful. Just kind of showing you guys what I've had. I've been meaning to make videos, I just have not had the, ever since I got back to work, time and effort to put stuff in. I even picked up check this bad boy. ...2022 membership token. Brand new. I think this is the new issue. So I gotta pop that in a capsule. I believe these are 39s. Can't remember. I don't know. I'll figure it out before the stream tonight. It's a pretty productive day. You know, I gotta say, I picked up a lot of decent stuff. I used my day well. Also picked up, these came in with an order that was on pre-order. I got some Welsh Dragons. He's got a worldwide mintage of 15K. These are 4.9 spine. I've had these before, but now I have them again. I love how like the background is like, it almost looks like dragon scales. These I didn't have. The Shamrock. Don't mind the stuff that's on the capsule. Sometimes these capsules don't come too well. But Shamrocks are cool. I got a little Irish in me, so I've actually wanted these Shamrocks for a while, and I finally got them. So that's pretty much it. I have a couple other things, but I'll show them later on the stream. So if you don't know, check our stream out on Steve Looking for Silver's channel, or tonight at 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific time. I'm really bad with time zones. 5 p.m. Mountain time and 6 p.m. Central time. So with that, guys, keep on stacking, keep on rocking. And as always, I'll see you later, baby. Woo! That's for MLZB. Number 4. Later, guys.